Your wrong priorities and the devastating consequences. Hello, welcome to this video. Today I want to talk about the topic that is very common that I hear all the time from leaders around the globe. And this is the topic of, let's ask a question first. Do you spend 99.9% of your time really fully in control, fully in charge, and always prioritize exactly how you want it to be? Always put the important before the urgent, if at all possible, or not. If that's the case, you don't need to watch this video, by the way, but then you are really just an absolute minority. The most of the people, most of us, most of the leaders really have this challenge that we get all the time burning issues on our plate, that we are driven, that we attend meetings where we ask ourselves, why should we attend them, etc., etc. So we are basically not in charge of most of the time of our day, or at least a large extent of our day. Why is this, by the way? And this is an interesting thing about the brain, how it is working just on a very, very high level. It's like that most of our, and this you probably know, most of our decisions and what we really focus on is driven by our subconscious mind, not our conscious mind. It runs on autopilot. However, we can influence it very much. And how do we influence it? Basically by two things, by strong emotions. This is very powerful for the subconscious mind, and there's a reason for that from evolution side. And by constant repetition. And here comes the point. Most of the time, when we repeat something and do it over and over again, like, let's make this example, like attending meetings where we're not sure that we really do should, right? Many leaders, maybe you are one of them, are really running from meeting to meeting, back to back, very often almost the entire day, and say, okay, ask at the end of the day, what have I really achieved? This is the thing, because you program your subconscious mind all the time that meetings are good, even if they aren't. You know, because you do it with constant repetition, and this is the thing, so it's going like a vicious cycle. And the thing is this, if you want, you can exactly also turn this around. You can program your subconscious mind by other things, but you need to do them repeatedly and or better is attach strong emotions to this. So I give you some more examples. If you that are an indicator, if you spend most of your time problem solving instead of creating and future creating activities, then it's exactly one of the key reasons, because you love problem solving. You have always done it, so you do it over and over again. It's a typical case that somebody from a team becomes the leader of this team and continues to do the same stuff because they love to do it. It's in their comfort zone. They program their mind repeatedly to do it over and over again. They never get out. Hope you get the point. It's sometimes eye-opening for people. If I do my coaching with senior leaders, it's not difficult to understand, but it's eye-opening if you reflected really on yourself, what's going on in your mind all the time. Number two, if you keep going, doing the urgent things and always having in firefighter mode. I have leaders really that I'm coaching or having in group settings that constantly complain about, or at least mention, that they have so many things that they always need to put the fires out, that they have no time for strategic work, at least not enough time. The reason is as well this, you create this. It sounds so weird, but it's really true. You create this in the mind that it's really great to always have fires burning. And by this, they will be created, at least in your mind. And it's absolutely true. Look around. Some leaders don't have that. Why? It's not because there are less fires, it's just because they are not focusing on that. And even then it's running well. And number three, another indicator, just looking at my notes here, is if you spend, as I mentioned already, most of your time in meetings, it's also this, that are neither productive nor useful. And you have a huge amount of time that you spend there, invest there, with not really the output that it should be. I'm not denying that some meetings are really great and need to be there. But many meetings are maybe not. So meetings are a common suspect in terms of wasting time, productive resources. And this is also because we program ourselves that it's great to be in meetings. It feels good, right? Get my point, hopefully. I'm a bit provocative, of course, that I want to be. And here I have three steps how to get out of that. Very high level. If you want to get more in depth, you need a coaching. And coaching is absolutely great in this because you can really reflect on your situation. So please consider it if you think you really want to become better there. And just a 20% better use of your time, even 10%, is absolutely 10 times worth always the investment. That was just a little commercial here, but I can give you here the three key topics. And number one, you need to know what is important. It sounds so simple, but many leaders are not really sure what is really important. Write down and be very clear about what is important. And just a little tip as a leader, the people development of your team is always a top priority. And that is almost always important, but almost never urgent. And this is the point. That's exactly the point. That's why you don't do it repeatedly. Number two. So first is knowing. Second is plan what is important. It's good that we know. I know that strategy is important. I know that people development is important. And I look at your calendar and I don't see that. So you need to plan activities for that. Very as stupid as it sounds, but it's really true. You need to put in your calendar. For example, if your personal development for yourself is important, what it is most of the time, then you need to have coaching or something similar, at least a personal growth program that you go through, and you need to spend time in that. And number three, also so simple, do what's important. So not only know it, plan it, but also do it every day. Because as I said in the beginning, we do constantly, we repeat what we are doing constantly, right? Because our subconscious mind always judges about this, what is done repeatedly is important. So I do it again and again and again. It keeps me alive. So you need to get in the doing. So you need to know them, you need to plan the important activities, and you need to do them. And by this, gradually, you will improve your situation and hopefully set the right priorities that are not devastating. So I hope that helps. It was a lot of stuff in this normally very short video. I hope that gives you some ideas. If you have further questions, just contact me. If you like this video, forward it, like it as well, add your comments, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in one of the next videos.